In this video, I'm going to review the Meilong M3x3 and tell you guys why it's my main and why I highly recommend this puzzle. So first, let's quickly go over the review part. The puzzle is very, very smooth and fast. The puzzle is also magnetized out of the box. The magnets are on the moderate to weak side, which could be a bit stronger. However, I feel like this weaker to moderate magnet strength is going to appeal to more cubers. Corner cutting is pretty decent in this puzzle, doing these small cuts pretty effortlessly. Bigger cuts are harder to do sometimes, but especially with the magnets, these cuts shouldn't really be happening in your solves. Corner twisting is an issue. I'm getting them, I think, once every 100 solves, so it isn't a huge one. And of course, pops are no issue on this puzzle. There are two problems I have with this puzzle, which can be fixed pretty easily. One is that sometimes it is a bit unstable because of the weaker magnets. However, this can be fixed with stacking magnets to make them stronger. Also, this puzzle can get a bit too fast sometimes with its quite light turning. However, this can quickly be fixed with some heavier loop in the pieces. Overall, this puzzle is really, really amazing. It's pretty much my new main at this point, and I just broke my average 100 PB with this puzzle. Now, my previous main was a Mystic WRM, so the fact that I'm using this puzzle over that one shows a lot about how good this puzzle is. Even compared to stuff like the GAN XS or the Volk Elite, from trying those puzzles at comps, I think this puzzle can still be competitive with those. And the amazing thing about this puzzle is not only is it great, but it's only $6 and only a few dollars extra for the premium version. Now recently, there are some puzzles that are being released that are a bit pricey. Because of the fact that those puzzles are so expensive and puzzles like the Meilong M exist, I feel like there's no real reason to get those more expensive puzzles. Their performance can maybe be a bit better and they can maybe be a bit more adjustable. However, puzzles like the Meilong M, the Yuchilo Magic M, the MS, the Monster Go, and the RSM 2020, and the list goes on, those puzzles are so good for their much lower prices. So for beginner solvers and even advanced solvers, I'm pretty much recommending these puzzles all the time because they're so good, and even with their lower prices, they're still so competitive with higher level D3s. People might talk about adjustability, like adjusting the magnet strengths and spring tensions, which are available on more flagship puzzles, but not really these budget ones. However, I will argue that adjustability isn't really that important in puzzles. While it is cool to adjust magnet strength and spring tension, it really isn't necessary to make a cube good. You can always adjust these budget cubes by stacking magnets, using different loop setups, or even adjusting the tension of the screws. The 3x3 market is pretty much at the point that all 3x3s are pretty much equal in performance, and maybe there's an argument to buy another cube for personal preference. And the fact that budget cubes like this one are so competitive with flagship puzzles like those shows that buying those more expensive puzzles aren't really necessary. So in short, budget cubes like the Meilong M are super good these days. I would highly recommend picking this up, and even if you don't like it, it's only $6, so you don't have too much to lose with buying this puzzle. So yeah, that's a bit of a review of the Meilong M and why I think budget cubes are so good these days. This is really cool with the 3x3, but hopefully this trend with budget cubes being super good can extend to other puzzles. But yeah, that's it for this video. Thank you for watching, and see you guys in the next one.